Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. My name is Nuraini Sabitri Rumi Azwan from Bachelor of Science Biology UiTM Perlis. My supervisor name is Dr. Maisarah Binti Sarizan and today I'll be presenting my final year project presentation entitled Bioactivities of Mucus from Terrestrial Gastropod, a review. Gastropods is the largest class under the phylum Mollusca. They can adapt to the marine and also to the terrestrial habitat. But today we're going to talk about the terrestrial gastropods. Terrestrial gastropod is generally the land snails and slugs. The land snails is the one that have shells and also the soft body, while the slugs is the one that only have the soft body. Land snails and slugs are considered as invasive species as they can give a problem if they are available in our vegetable farms or garden. This is because they can cause a huge disruption to our crops. Currently, there are a lot of research have been done showing that terrestrial gastropod mucus had the potential to be as antimicrobial, antioxidant, antispasmodic, anti-cancer, anti-ulcer, and anti-diabetic. Next are my problem statement. My first problem statement is regarding Chain 2018 that indicates that the land snails and slugs are considered as invasive species. This is because they could become a huge problem and a great pest to the vegetable farms and garden. The second problem statement regarding Davis and Davis 2010, they indicates that this could help to overcome the problem of antimicrobial resistance that have become a concern nowadays. The significance of this study is where the finding of this review will provide benefits to the society, considering that bioactivities of the terrestrial gastropod mucus could play an important role, especially in the medicinal field. A greater demand for development of a new generation of natural product from the nature justifies that it need to be more effective and life-changing. Besides that, it could be such a great benefit to the agricultural economy since the snails and slug species are common and could be found in most of the crops area. The abundance of the land snails and slugs could be a great chance for the farmers or gardeners to gain profit from the snails by providing the snails to the medicinal and beauty industry. The objective of this study is to review the chemical composition of terrestrial gastropod mucus, to review the function of the mucus toward various application, and the third one is to review the bioactive compounds from the terrestrial gastropod mucus that has been isolated. The main research questions of this review are: what are the bioactivities that have been reported from terrestrial gastropods, mainly on land snails and slugs? There are several other research questions also have been developed. Mollusks. Regarding to Plowin 2020, mollusks are one of the main groups in the animal kingdom. There are almost 100,000 to 150,000 described species that have been found by scientists until today. Mollusks are ecologically and structurally different in various forms. Gastropoda is one of the class under the phylum gastropods. According to Berkendorf 2010, their habitat ranges from the highest alpine regions to the deepest sea vents, and they have adapted to a variety of lifestyle including predatory, herbivorous, scavenging, detritivorous, filter feeding, and even some symbiotic photo and chemoautotrophic niche. Hasbrunner and Wenninger 2012 indicates that mollusks are a phylum that exhibits such a striking variety morphological phenotype. Next, for gastropods, Klappenbach 2018 indicates that there are 60,000 to 80,000 described species, which comprise about 80% of living mollusks. Solem 2020 indicates snails typically have shell, while the shellless one are referred to as slugs. Plowin 2020 indicates that terrestrial gastropods commonly found on rocky, arenaceous, and muddy area. Gastropods are mainly found in shallow water, benthic population, but some were also found live in the deep sea. On the other side, slugs can grow up to 10 inches in length. Most slugs are light brown or grey in the colour. Slug skin is extremely moist and it is frequently covered in a thin coat of sticky mucus that helps it retain moisture while also protecting it from predators who dislike the taste. Mucus composition of terrestrial gastropods are, regarding to Pawlicki et al. 24, they indicate that there are 90 to 99% of terrestrial gastropods weight or consists of water in their mucus. Regarding to Momo et al. 2019, they said that snail mucin have some nutricutical application addition to some other numerous function in the body from the results that the combination of various mucin extract with the twin 18 yielded emulsion with a very high stability. Paris et al. 2012 indicates that snail slime consists of glycosaminoglycan that can bind to Cooper peptide that is important for biological function as bacterial protein binding receptor. And Celia and Fratini 2018 also indicates that snail slime consists of various micromolecules and many bioactive components that have been identified. Next, function and applications of terrestrial gastropod mucus. Firstly, regarding to Denny 1973, for terrestrial gastropods, the secreted viscoelastic mucus gels comes with 15 functions that include feeding, protection, reproduction, locomotion, lubrication, defense and adhesion. Next is cosmetic industry. Regarding to Celia and Fratini, snail mucus has the potential to provide a good moisturizing effect for skin to stimulate the formation of collagen, elastin, and dermal component that repair the sign of photoaging and also reduce the damage generated by free radicals. Also, as one healing product, as indicated by Rosanto et al., where different concentrations of snail mucus gel reveal to have different effects on angiogenesis during the healing of punch biopsy once on the back skin of Mr. Rex. Antimicrobial is a substance or material that has the primary function of killing the microbe triggering to LGS 2018. A study by Nantaran et al. 2019 indicates that Acatina furica shows an inhibitory and bactericidal effect against Staphylococcus aureus, MRSA, Staphylococcus epidermis, and Chronobacterium species. Next, Ulagesan and Kim 2018 also indicates that protein obtained from snail Cryptozoona bisterellis soft bodies showed highest antimicrobial activity against the pathogenic bacteria. Next, a study by Nutuan et al. 2021 indicates that antimicrobial activity on Lysacatina furica and Hemipacta distincta exhibited antimicrobial activity against all four tested bacterial strains. Last but not least, Ahmad et al. 2021 study shows that Acatina marginata has also showed to contain antibacterial agents against clinical wounds. Next is antioxidant. Nutuan et al. 2021 indicates that mucus from bull snail, Lysacatina furica and Hemipacta distincta showed an antioxidant activity with a lower EC50 found in the mucus of Lysacatina furica than Hemipacta distincta. Next study by Breva et al. 28 said that antioxidant superoxide dismutase SOD and glutathione S transferase GST has been isolated from the mucus of Cryptomphalus aspersa. Next, Ulagesa et al. 2018 indicates that papain digested hydroxylase from C. bisterellis could potentially become one of the natural antioxidant compound. Next is anti-inflammatory. Rosanto et al. 2021 study indicates that average number of new blood vessels generated in the 48% and 96% of Lysacatina furica snail mucus treatments group has decreased on day 7 compared to day 4. This is because the wound healing process is accelerated by a higher snail mucus content and a greater number of observation days. Next, Harty et al. 2018 study said that chitosan 5% and 5% of snail scream mucus showed that the best result in terms of lymphocyte proliferation activity in vitro. Also, a study by Guptisa et al. 2020 indicates that nanoparticles from slime sample of Helix aspersa mulla, a terrestrial gastropods, have been shown to promote successful wound healing and may pave the way for faster wound healing in difficult to heal wounds. And last but not least, Guia et al. 2020 also indicates that slime extracted from giant African snails has anti-inflammatory properties in vitro and in vivo. Next is antispasmodic. Pons et al. 1998 has indicates that there are bronchorelaxant effects of helicidin where mucoglycoprotein is used as cough suppressant from the lens near helicomatia. Helicidin is one of the contents in snail mucus. A study by Conte 2016 indicates that helicidin could relax the airway smooth muscles acting on it and activating the intermediary epithelial cells to release bronchorelaxant agent. This shows that snail mucus may have the potential as antispasmodic due to this discovery. Next is anti-ulcer. Regarding to Nodo et al. 29, they indicates that snail slime showed that there are substantial anti-ulcer effect on indomethacin stress and histamine-induced ulcer. Next, Guadliendo et al. 2021 also indicates that snail secretion filtrate from Helix aspersa mulla mucus has a substantial protective effect on microscopic and histological lesion as well as mucus content, oxidative stress, and inflammatory response. Also, Carlo et al. 2019 study on Acatina marginata mucin used on aggressive factor of gastric ulcer in Wistaria stomach tissue showed that there are decrease in gastric juice volume and acid output with a concurrent decrease in gastric juice volume and acid output. Anti-cancer. Ecobone et al. 2016 predict that there are putative anti-cancer peptides from the most efficient HPLC isolated mucus fractions against the breast cancer cell line MCF7. The MTT assay was used to test the cytotoxicity of the crude Acatina furica mucus and seek HPLC separated fractions against the breast cancer cell line MCF7, and the fraction F2 and F5 significantly promoted cell death. Next is a study by Elgemi et al. 2018 indicates that Helix aspersa maxima snail slime was found to have anti-tumor effect against human myeloma cells in addition to treating melogenesis. Owa et al. 2017 also indicates that Helix aspersa extract shows anti-cancer action in HS578T cells and it is a robust TNF-alpha stimulator and a good NFKB inhibitor. Montesuwick et al. 2018 study also indicates that there are viability of KECO2 colon cancer cell line was found to be reduced after the extract from lyophilized mucus and food tissues of Helix aspersa mulla were applied. Last but not least, a study by Duet et al. 21 regarding snail mucus as an anti-cancer indicates that Helix pomatia species also got an evidence that the lectin from Helix pomatia agglutinin recognized oligosaccharides linked to anti-cancer with a poor prognosis. Last one is anti-diabetic. A study by Barmenas et al. 2017 indicates that there was a blood glucose reduction for all doses 100 mg per kilogram and 300 mg per kilogram of snail slime from giant African snail. The ability of the snail slime to regenerate cells and the fact that diabetes is marked by damage to pancreatic beta cells led to this investigation for anti-diabetic activity. As a conclusion, there is still a lot of research gap that need to be covered in certain topics, especially in antifungal, antidiabetic, and antispasmodic. And also, a lot of research need to be done on slugs because there is not much slug bioactivity research have been done. Also, from the review, we can see that chemical composition of snail mucus are allantoin, helicidin, agglutinin, collagen, and glycolic. They also have heparin sulfate. From the review, also we can see that the function of terrestrial gastropods are beneficial for the organism itself as lubricant, locomotion, and also with function that include feeding, protection, reproduction, locomotion, lubrication, defense, and adhesion. It also beneficial for human, especially in cosmetic industries as it have a great effect on moisturizing and anti-aging properties, and also it shown a great wound healing product. Next, for antimicrobial bioactivities, These four species had shows a positive result, which is the Lysacarthina follica, Cryptozoona bistarellus protein fraction, Hemiplecta distincta, and Arcatina marginata. For antioxidant, the species that has shown a positive result is Lysacarthina follica, Helix aspersa, Corneum aspersum, and Cryptozoona bistarellus. For anti-diabetic, it's only the Arcatina follica, while for anti-cancer, also the Arcatina follica and Helix aspersa. For anti-ulcer, Arcatina marginata and Helix aspersa mula. And last one, for anti-inflammatory, is the Arcatina follica and Helix aspersa mula. As for the recommendation, research regarding antimicrobial activity of terrestrial gastropod should be done more on bacterial and fungal that specifically cause skin disease. More research need to be done and narrow down species and type of terrestrial gastropods that are suitable to be harvested in order to avoid overuse and extinction of the species. Last but not least, build a terrestrial gastropod farm system, which is the heliculture, to make the snails and start harvesting controlled and can be monitoring their reproduction that's suitable to fulfill the industry demand.